My guest today is somebody who has had a massive influence on my life. First through Pret à Manger, which he started, and latterly with Itsu, which is rather more healthy. So I'm very, very pleased to welcome Julian Metcalfe. Julian, thank you.
It's an honour to be here.
Thank you for joining today. I know this is not the most original question, but tell me a little bit about how it first started. Why did you start Pret?
I think we'll start with the fact I couldn't do anything else. I was not very employable. I really honestly was one of those people who had to work for themselves.
Yeah.
Number one, I mean, I think because if I did work for myself, I realised that I'd put everything into it, as long as I could find something I enjoyed. And secondly, no one was doing back then what I wanted to do, which was to sell better food. So Pret à Manger came out of a strong desire to sell tasty, good, nutritious, really kind of wonderful food at a price which people could afford.
When you first started the business, what was it? You just opened a shop?
No, of course not. No. Like you, I'm sure you struggle like crazy. The first Pret à Manger shop was a complete horror story, and for two years it lost money.
Were you working in the shop every day, 7 days a week?
Yeah, but I had dreams and an aspiration that I'd have a manager. So I employed a manager who told me what to do all the time. And it took me a couple of years before I got fed up with being told that I was wrong and he was right. We didn't see eye to eye on this vision, because my vision, like many people, the vision was fluffy. It was, let's try and do this food beautifully at an affordable. But what food? I kept on changing the menu. One minute I had budget rolls, and then I had lamb, a roast leg of lamb sandwiches being carved in front of you. I mean, we tried everything.
Yeah.
And then finally we put everything in a box and we said, no, there's no choice anymore. Take it or leave it. You know how much love and care and good stuff goes into this box. So if you want to be in and out of here in a minute, yeah, buy the box, yeah, or don't come at all. I was convinced we were going to go bust, but I was so exhausted after 2 years. And it, quite the opposite happens. They poured in, they bought their boxes and they were out. And we had the most, I'll never forget it, the lunch rush was over by 1:20. Everyone was calm, and we had more money in the till than ever before. Mm.
Did you ever make any real sort of huge single mistake?
But it's a
one particular one.
And every day, I still do now. I should think 3 out of every 6 decisions I make each week are still wrong. When you spend too much of your time doing things you're really bad at, because you have to, that's when the mistakes really come, I think.
What are you really
bad
at?
Well, I was not particularly interested in the numbers and the figures weekly of our company. Yeah. I was not interested remotely in going to sit with the lawyers.
Or yeah, the boring stuff.
The boring stuff, the hierarchy stuff, and the management and the checking and the, you get what you inspect, not what you expect, yeah, type of thing. In my career over time, that has cost me a few times very, very dearly.
So when you've had those really tough times, especially now with COVID, but you know, there are people with their own businesses facing really tough decisions. What advice do you give people when they're feeling really down?
I think if you look back at history, all businesses which have done well, it's because there's a reasonably clear vision. In other words, somebody or a group of people have managed to share what is that exactly trying to do.
So you have now done that?
So we've done that. But it's still, I do find it very, very, very difficult. Someone asked me last week, why on earth don't you charge a lot more?
It depends whether you want to sell, you know, very few at a very high price or a lot at a very low,
sure,
price. And that's a decision you need to make pretty early on.
And that decision should come from the vision,
yeah,
which is, who are my customers? Without that, I think it's really difficult to sell a shirt or a glass or a fork,
yeah,
or a cushion or a worktop.
I think you often talk about the importance of emotions and empathy and well-being in the workplace. How's it all changed? How's that all changed?
Well, I mean, it's such an enormous subject. If you want to make and produce a product you're proud of and your customers really value, it's going to be very hard unless you can create a working environment where the people who make that product and serve that product and pack up and box that product aren't proud. You know, we live in a world where so much we're targeted to make results in a really very short period of time.
Yeah.
The difference between your business and the one I started, I think, is because you take a 10, 20, 30, 40 year view.
But is that a difference between the two businesses?
Well,
or do you have the same?
Personally, I think you see businesses often with great, fantastic, deep culture, because they take a very long-term,
yeah,
view.
But do you have a long-term view?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
And I'm not, some people who work with me would think they'd be surprised by me talking like this because I'm probably quite a demanding person to work
you
for.
You want things now, but equally you want, but that's with a...
But I, above all else, want the people I work with to feel totally respected and give them an enormous amount of trust. Yeah.
How is the founder of a business that's growing, how do you make sure that your values and your beliefs and what you believe about empathy gets, you know, carries on right through the business?
God, it's such a good question. I mean, I think the answer to the question probably is try and build within the organisation a structure where the ideas, you're close to home, close to where it really matters, you've got enough good people.
Yeah.
All the success from my career has come from people bubbling up with our ideas who we've then given positions of authority to. The CEO of my grocery business is 31 years old or something. Absolutely remarkable.
Is ambition good? Are you an ambitious person?
Well, I think without ambition and drive and grit, you're not going to get anywhere.
What is your ambition?
My ambition with Itsu is to grow and grow and challenge the great mighty fast food people.
But was that your ambition with Pret as well?
Yes.
Because I really want to ask you is why did you sell Pret?
I had another shareholder who's took an opportunity to do very different things with his life. And in the end, getting things done the way I wanted them done became harder and harder and harder and harder. And I was wasting so much of my energy and emotional energy dealing with a sort of corporate thing.
Yeah.
Rather than with Itsu, we don't really have that so much. We're still able to plow on and do wonderful work. It's still tiny because we're trying to challenge giants, global giants. Very soon in between Kentucky and Kentucky Fried Chicken and McDonald's, we're opening a brand new site with 180 seats.
Whereabouts?
It's in Reading.
Oh, in Reading. Yeah. Oh, wow.
And that's the dream, to see our place packed with people spending the same amount of money.
It will be the same. It is the same amount of money,
well,
isn't it?
I mean,
pretty much.
£7.10 a head. And I'm not sure, when did you last have a bargain bucket?
I haven't had a bargain bucket for a while.
Right. But it's about £7.
The trouble is, I mean, if somebody gave me a bargain bucket, I would demolish the whole thing, probably a 22p or whatever the largest one is.
That is, I think it is.
I can very happily.
Yeah.
You once said that your business would grow slowly and beautifully. Do you think there's a...
So my idea of beautifully, what I meant was everything. So the feeling and the look in the eye of the people who work there, and the look in the eyes of the people who shop there, and the product itself. A bit like they do things, you know, in Japan. There's this respect and love.
Yeah.
It's just non-negotiable. It's so beautiful. The food side of Japan is enthralling.
So Itsu will be around in 100 years?
I don't know about 100 because anything could have happened. But in 10 years from now, I bet it's really, really, people are really noticing it. Yeah. Because people crave better nutrition at an affordable price. They're craving it. Yes.
Do you think people will come back to work?
That's a good question. Yeah, I think as humans, we need to be together. We always have, we always will. So I get frustrated on Zoom, I don't know about you, but I find after a few months of it, I'm fed up with it.
Yeah.
It's just, everyone's distracted doing their own thing.
Yeah.
You can't really see the whites of their eyes. You can't really see the emotional tension when people are being brave.
Yeah.
You know, when they're really, really sticking their neck out and
absolutely.
Sharing their concerns and trying to make change. Can't do that on Zoom. I think common sense probably helps, actually. You have to have a certain amount of common sense, don't you think, in business?
Common sense is an interesting one because I always thought it's all about common sense.
Yeah.
You know, but what I found is that I ended up making a lot of mistakes. The whole concept of having a mentor didn't really exist.
No. Do you have mentors now?
Well, I don't really have mentors now, but I sort of wish I did. And I certainly wish I did when I was earlier in the business because they would have stopped me making those mistakes. Do you have a mentor now?
Yeah, I mean, we bought some really senior, capable people into the company.
They're and do
really
they give top, you top and they give you very good advice?
Of course they do.
And you listen.
Bloody right, I listen.
Yeah, I love entrepreneurs who have a long-term view of the business.
It's key, isn't it?
Yeah, I loved your quote about growing in as slowly and beautifully, whether you said it or not.
Yeah, no, I hope I did, because that is very much my goal.
Yeah,
you want to build things which are there for a very, very long time.
Yeah. I've got a few quick-fire questions I wanted to ask
you.
The first one is, what is the best cuisine in the world?
Well, for me, Japanese by far.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Do you cook from scratch or order in? That's quite a difficult question.
We cook more from scratch.
Right.
But I do order in a lot, mainly out of interest and study, you know.
What book is on your bedside table?
Right today, there's a book there with an orange cover called Contagious, which is a recently written book about the emotional triggers, which really, why are we in love with our Apple or a Land Rover car? What is it which really triggers our emotions. Fascinating, fascinating part of the brain.
Julian, it's been an absolute pleasure.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure too.
It's been, I am a great admirer and I will carry on eating itsu and losing weight.
Good, wonderful.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.